moments. I was in the rally literally two blocks from here where he said that he was going to turn himself in. The crowd said no, no, no. They called on him to resist, and his speech lasted for 1 hour. This was the first time he had spoken to anybody in public over the last 48 hours while he was holed up in the Metal Workers Union. It was a very moving speech. He spoke to, it was almost like a passing of the baton. He spoke to the creation of a new movement with new leaders coming from kind of the grassroots and coming from the youth. And that was one of the major themes. The other major themes was, you know, he is going to jail. It's the loss of one combatant within a larger context, and that this is going to even build the movement even larger, that everyone is Lula. In fact, the very end, the chant was, "We are Lula, we are Lula." That was the chant, you know, sounding out throughout the crowd. So he has said he's going to be turning himself in. He also said that this was part of a deal that they had struck yesterday, in which they were able to stay, you know, overnight into today. He had the mask. This is reports that we had heard, but nothing was confirmed. And now it's been confirmed. It was part of the deal. So now he's headed to Curitiba. I don't have the logistics of exactly how that's going to happen. One other detail I do think is interesting. One of the people up on the stage called for people to go to Curitiba, called for, you know, mass mobilizations in Curitiba, not to defend him against prison, but to be there to support him. So that might be the next step.
And for those who are not immersed in Brazil's politics, just remind us the background to all of this. Why are we here?
Good question. Lula, former president of the country, one of the most, he left literally with an approval rating of over 80%, one of the most successful presidents on record. Late last year, he was accused and convicted of corruption for accepting an apartment in exchange for contracts, bribes. He's been free since then. They went to appeals court just in January. That appeals court upheld the conviction against him. Now, he says he's innocent. His supporters say he's innocent. He says it's based off on plea bargain testimony, that there's no evidence. But this is going forward. Just a few days ago, like you said, the Supreme Court, the Supreme Federal Court said there would no, they wouldn't put forward an injunction to stop the imprisonment. And that's why we are here today.
He was holding out. I mean, the deadline passed for him to give himself in. Why the change of mind, if this is a change of mind?
I think it part of it is the image, right? Part of it is doing it on his own terms. One way would be kind of sulking to the police station in Curitiba. Another way is doing this, having this big hurrah, having this kind of passing of the baton. And I think it was also very interesting in the fact that his supporters just 2 hours ago during the same mass, during the same mobilization right here in San Bernardo do Campo, were adamant that he should not turn himself in. But after an hour-long speech of him explaining where he came from, of him going through the motions, I think he was able to really quell the crowd to understand why he was going himself. But also, you know, one of the things that was repeated over and over again was the need for continued resistance, the need for continued kind of grassroots organizing, peaceful grassroots organizing, nonviolent grassroots organizing was stressed throughout the entire talk. And I think those were the main themes they really wanted to touch on. And I think that resonated also with the federal police and everything else, which is why I think the deal was struck yesterday.